Clutch cable slack or free play adjustment. A simple yet vital maintenance task to ensure seamless gear shifts, proper clutch operation, and clutch longevity. To ensure proper clutch operation, the clutch lever free play is an essential maintenance task for your bike. I'm Dr. Vstrom, and I'm going to show you how to set up your clutch lever free play in this video. Now, what is clutch lever free play? It's this free movement of the lever where, in a sense, the only thing moving is the clutch lever and the clutch cable a bit. Improper slack or free play in the clutch cable leads to the following. Less slack leads to clutch slip as the plates are not fully pressed together when the clutch lever is out. If this happens, there is a high risk of glazing the clutch plates, and at some point you will need to replace them. On the other hand, excessive cable slack or clutch free play does not allow full disengagement when the lever is pulled, and that makes it hard to shift gears. To accurately check and adjust the free play, you need a simple tape measure or a ruler, but above all, a cold engine, as warm clutch plates tend to expand and affect the measurements. Now, a few words about the clutch operation. When the clutch lever is out, the pressure plate pushes the clutch pack or the pack of clutch plates, so the inner hub and the outer basket are locked together. In other words, the engine can drive the rear wheel. On the other hand, when the clutch lever is pulled in, the pressure plate is pushed away from the clutch pack, so the inner hub and the outer basket spin independently or are decoupled. The engine can no longer pass power to the rear wheel. The first part is to remove the handguard. It will make life and the whole process easier. There's a video up here on how to remove, reinstall, and improve the OEM handguards. There are actually a few places where the clutch free play can be adjusted. The first part is where the clutch lever is. It's a barrel adjuster, which usually is below or inside a rubber protection, like in this case. So, and there are some associating locking nuts and other adjusting nuts. Normally, a second place for larger adjustments is where the front sprocket is. It's a set of lock nuts in the engine. This is for bigger changes, but in the case of third generation Vstroms, it's not an adjustment area anymore. In the past and in older Vstrom generations, as shown also in the image, there used to be a clutch release rod or push rod, and this mechanism was very accessible on the left side here where the front sprocket is, and you could access this mechanism and adjust or finer adjust the clutch or the clearance with this rod by making turns on a small screw. But in this last generation, this mechanism is no longer accessible from the left hand side, and instead you have to remove the right hand side engine cover. You need to replace a gasket when you put it back. You need to remove also the engine oil and also remove the coolant, and that's a lot of work. Now let's adjust the clutch cable free play or slack.
while on a cold engine so that our measurements are correct, as the clutch plates tend to expand when they are warm. We're going to adjust the clutch cable free play using the lock nut, the adjuster nut, this adjuster nut, and this lock nut. Remove the clutch cable boot. Loosen the lock nut, this large nut. So turn it clockwise. This will give some space here so that we can then move the adjuster. You have to take into account not to reach the end of the bolt or the edge of the bolt to a place where it will wobble up and down. By wobble, I mean this small movement, you see? I can move the bolt up and down because I have turned it clockwise quite a bit. So find the place where it's the maximum, where the bolt cannot be moved up and down. And in this case, we want to give extra slack so that our cable is loose. To do this, we turn the adjuster anti-clockwise. With a wrench of size 12, loosen the cable lock nut, the one on the bottom. So spin it clockwise. Now the main adjustment, or the large adjustment, is going to be made with this adjuster nut, and we will adjust this so that the free play on our clutch lever is between 10 to 15 millimeters. When this large adjuster is turned clockwise, the free play increases. When it is turned anti-clockwise, the free play is reduced. So we will play with this adjuster nut until we get at this side a free play of 10 to 15 millimeters. Take your ruler, and as you can see, the bolt diameter is approximately 2 centimeters, so the middle is at 1. Mark this. Place your ruler perpendicular to the handlebar. Your ruler zero line should be pointing to the blue line that we made with our marker. The ruler is above the clutch lever, so the clutch lever can move freely. Pull the lever in and read the indication on the ruler with the blue line. It's 1 or 10 millimeters. Play with the cable adjuster nut and increase this from 10 millimeters to between 10 and 50 millimeters so that we are certain that we are not outside limits. For this, turn the cable clutch adjuster nut clockwise to get a little bit more slack. Don't forget, a very important thing to note is that on the side of the engine where the clutch cable is, and this arm for the clutch, this arm together with the clutch cable, their angle should be no less than 80 degrees and no more than 90. So this angle has got to be between 80 and 90 degrees. So when you adjust, you have to maintain these degrees. Once you're done with the lower large adjusting nut, turn the lower lock nut anti-clockwise so as to secure the adjuster nut and the setting that we have made. Take your wrenches, your 10 and 12 wrench, and tight this into position. Currently, with the general setting from the lower adjuster nut, we are at almost 15 millimeters or 14 millimeters. So now we will make a finer adjustment through the upper adjuster nut next to the clutch lever. Turn the upper clutch adjuster nut clockwise a bit, because we want to reduce the slack. Now we take our ruler once more and we measure, and the distance is now around 12 to 13 millimeters, which is ideal. So the next step is to take our lock nut, the upper lock nut, and tight it to secure also this adjustment. Once you're done, take the clutch cable boot and cover the adjuster and lock nut like so, and this cover, this rubber cover also here, and you're done. Once all adjustments are made, a good way to check for proper clutch operation is to start the engine, engage into first gear. At this point the wheel should not be turning. Then when I release the clutch, the wheel is turning, and as soon as I grab the clutch, it should stop fairly quickly. That means that our clutch is operating correctly. Once you're done with the adjustments and the checks, last thing is to make sure that your clutch cable is within this metal bracket to secure it, and then move your handlebars around and make sure that the cable is not inhibited in any way. Alright, hope you enjoyed this Dr. Vstrom how-to video. To continue, refer to the next video link up here or up here on how to reinstall your pair of handguards, if you have one.